today from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. This is the National Football League. We'll see Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys taking on Mac Jones and the New England Patriots.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas, in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the New England Patriots taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Two teams more than ready to get this one started. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
It's over, it's over, let's dominate.
Well, the Patriots offense set to go to work with Mac Jones at quarterback in his third season now out of Alabama.
It was a much rockier season for Jones in his second year, and he even had to survive a brief challenge to his starting job. This is a big campaign for the former Rookie of the Year runner-up. He wants to get back to Pro Bowl form in this one.
Jones wants to throw to start things out here. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. The Cotton Bowl MVP in this stadium in 2020, Ramondre Stevenson. And he's going to have a Patriots first down as he'll get this up to about the 42.
That's a very nice game there, a confidence-building run. Love the execution up front, and the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Throwing Jones over the middle, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Second and a couple. Out of the gun, they give it to Stevenson. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and 1 is now 3rd and 3.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Now Jones. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. It'll be a pickup of four, good enough to earn him yet another first down.
Well, they kept it simple there, CD, only needing the short gain to move the chain, so they didn't want to go with a deep throw. They just go with that safer, shorter throw and able to convert.
Nothing wrong with that at all, partner. Check the box, right? Make sure you pick up the first down. Offense is getting established. You're moving the ball. You're not turning it over. Check, check, check. They like what they're doing early in the game.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Off play action, Jones. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
Offense is moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earn a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Now a second and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. He'll get this into the hands of Stevenson. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 30. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Again, he'll drop to throw. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. And how about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays. Throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
Second and 1 now from the 21. Back to throw again. He completes it to Henry. And Henry's going to pick up a Patriots first down as he's down inside the 15. That one good for 7 as this long drive continues and the chains move again.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays at that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism. Great hand up.
And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Defensive end, DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat.
Lawrence, if somebody remains a fearsome rusher off the edge, even if the sack totals aren't as high as they used to be. But 17 forced fumbles over the last 6 seasons proves he's still getting the job done.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Straight ahead, it's Stevenson. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. No score after 1 on EA Sports. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, here's Stevenson. And he'll be tackled after a gain of 4, still 3 yards short, fourth down.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now the rookie fourth round pick Chad Ryland for the Patriot field goal. From the right hash here should be an easy one.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. So a nice opening drive on the road. You get the 3 points. Part of you wonders if that might hurt them later not getting into the end zone.
Well, the good thing is still first quarter, and they did come out of it with points. In a sense, they could look at it positively and say, hey, we set the pace in this one. I think that's how they'll go about it.
Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. So the Cowboys ready to go on offense for the first time, and it is their now 30-year-old quarterback, Dak Prescott, who leads the way.
And the first possession isn't until the second quarter, but what's nice about it, it's only down 3. So what you sell your team on is, look, one possession, one drive, we put it in the end zone, we're in the lead in this game. Let's go, guys.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 27. And throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 23 yards on the play.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days, but you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred a defense.
Play fake. Here's Prescott. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Four minutes to play here in quarter number two. They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
They'll see about converting this 3rd and 8. Prescott now. Now he's flushed out right. And he will be out of bounds, but there is a flag down. And I suspect this might not be a legal pass. So since that last play got nothing, they'll go ahead and decline the penalty. And that forces a 4th down situation. And the Cowboys going to bring on Brian Anger to punt on 4th down. And the all-pro return man Marcus Jones deep for New England. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. So back onto the field come the Pats for their 2nd drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other. And maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards. And now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them? And do I have enough confidence to make a play?
To throw on 2nd down.
Jones, complete. Hunter Henry with a grab.
And Henry's going to pick up a Patriots first down as he'll get this up past the 40.
Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down. Now that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime report.
Need to give the coach some hot. And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack.
Damone Clark fought his way through and buried him behind the line.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. It's complete to Parker, left side. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 35. A nice pickup of 17 yards.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Jones now on first and 10. And hitting Juju on the slant. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Jones throw taken in by Bourne. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. They'll look to throw again. That's to the running back, Ramondre Stevenson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Here's second and 2 now from the 3.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
That's to the pylon and incomplete.
Shut him down! Shut him down! Let's do this!
After the incompletion, here now, third and 2.
They'll try and run for the first with Stevenson.
And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score.
Ramondre Stevenson.
A 3 yard touchdown run.
And the Patriots will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Chad Ryland now to add the PAT. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it was polished off by a Ramondre Stevenson touchdown run. Back out is the kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. And the Cowboys going to go on offense one final time in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Yeah, they're just going to run it here up the middle. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. Here's Prescott. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Prescott on first down. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it, so on comes the field goal unit. This will approach NFL record territory. It's a 62-yard attempt, and this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. Well, I don't know if you ever go into a game expecting to attempt a kick of 62 yards. Charles, not only attempt it, but make it one of the longest kicks that we've ever seen.
Yeah, I'm not sure you ever go into a game expecting to kick one of this distance, but all the better kickers, they do dream of it, and they show what they can do in practice and convince their coaches to give them a chance. That one surely paid off.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports halftime report. We saw a solid first half from the Oklahoma man, Ramondre Stevenson. He had a touchdown run that helped get his guys this halftime lead.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
As they begin their second half here, Charles, offensively, you know, not where they want to be, obviously. They're losing in this ball game, but very much within striking distance. We'll see what adjustments they make in the second half.
Is that the old glass half full, half empty type of a deal? Which way do you want to look at it? Because you're right, they're down on the scoreboard, but they're definitely opportunities now, because if they want to go ahead and get going in this one, get back to the running game. I think there are going to be some places to go with it, and I think the offensive line will appreciate the chance to fire out and hit people.
That's a good point, because they virtually had nothing going in the ground game in that first half. On second down, here's a keeper by the QB. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it, and while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
Third and two. I got you, son. Throwing, Prescott. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they get five there on third and two.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And a 5 yard gain gets him to the 42.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Gonna run again here with Pollard. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That's now consecutive 5 yard carries to pick up the first down.
I know flashy plays as people like to call them, that attracts a lot of attention. But let's face it, when you're efficient, that can control a ball game, and I love the game plan they've got going right now.
Back-to-back 5 yard gains, didn't force the ball downfield, picked it up on the ground.
Yeah, offensive line, they're getting it done.
Dak there, throwing complete to Cooks. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A really nice gain of 25 yards. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over, that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Prescott to throw it. That is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, 28 yards. And the Cowboys are within an extra point of tying up this ball game.
When we draw up defenses on the board, we do account for every receiver. But on that particular play, somehow he was wide open, became an easy touchdown pass.
Extra point attempt to follow here. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it's finished off by the touchdown from CeeDee Lamb. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This taken in at the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. So here are the Patriots now. They get ready for their first possession of half number two. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on, catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Ball on the 30 now. Here's 2nd and 3. Up the middle. Here's Stevenson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
No surprise to see Stevenson making that type of a play. People know him well. Unsurprised to see him over 1,000 yards this past season. He's a bruiser who was also 4th among backs with 69 catches. He can do it all in the New England offense.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up 1st and 10. Back to throw. Jones. Throw out wide is incomplete.
No receivers open downfield, so instead of forcing the ball to the sideline, he's going to throw this one down to Fort Worth. He'd rather have the incompletion than the turnover.
Dallas, Texas is the spot. 3rd quarter inside AT&T Stadium. Glad you're with us. 2nd and 10. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. First target, first catch, and a first down.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. Looking to throw. Jones finding Bourne here over the middle. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 17 more yards. They had 17 on the previous snap as well. 3 quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. On the draw is Stevenson. Heck of a move and then brought down near the 23. 43 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
And Stevenson's going to have a Patriots 1st down as he'll be brought down just outside the red zone. Mark him at the 21.
My high school football coach was very fond of saying, you've got to meet force with force. And on a short yardage running play, that's what you're going to encounter. And how about them picking up the 1st down on that one?
Jones on 1st down. They set up the screen for Stevenson. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up 1st and goal.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens because if he starts feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness against them.
Setting up a screen for Stevenson. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
On second down, it's Stevenson, and he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a pickup of 3, but still a little work to do on 3rd and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Throw left side complete. That's Parker. Touchdown, Patriots. Devontae Parker, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the 4th. So, Charles, this game feels like it has been punch, counterpunch all throughout, and that touchdown breaks our tie here in the 4th quarter.
You're making me want to get back in the gym and start training again. You talk about those punches and counterpunches. I also think this is where you and I start thinking to ourselves, who's going to make the play to change that, right? Who's going to get out of this little cycle that they're in right now and make a play and give their team a firm advantage?
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And that makes it a 17-10 score. So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. So Dak and the Cowboys trailing 17-10, 2:22 on the clock. Deuces wild. Plenty of time here. They've got 3 timeouts and the 2-minute warning as they've got it 1st and 10. A first down throw for Prescott. And that's complete to Cooks. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a 2nd down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. Here's 2nd and a yard. Prescott into the hands of Cooks. This is where, of course, it's good to have a veteran quarterback under center.
You would just be able to put out one of those blood pressure clips, and nothing would be different for him. He's done it many times before, expects to get it accomplished again.
Here's 1st down. Now Prescott. He finds his man, Pollard. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Now 2nd down and a few inches. Here's Dak. Left side to Lamb.
And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 35. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
Here's first and 10. Now Dak.
That's into the hands of Gallup over the middle.
And remember, field goal does them no good in this situation.
You got to think they should be taking some shots for the end zone soon.
Here comes second down. Here's Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And Lamb going to have a Cowboys first down as he'll get this down to the 23.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now. To throw, Prescott. And that one too wide and incomplete.
A lot of practice time, a lot of thinking goes into two-minute drills, even on the defensive side. So now you want to make sure the guys understand. Continue to be aggressive, but make sure you're smart in doing so.
They'll try again here, second and 10.
Here's Prescott.
Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb.
And he's taken down after a gain of three as they move it from the 22 to the 19. They still got two timeouts. Got to start using them, don't they?
You absolutely have to. You save them for this situation, but you have to use them.
The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ballgame.
Here now, third down.
Prescott to throw.
A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
And now time for one final play that has to be obviously in the end zone.
Can't wait to see what they call, but you want to get it to your best player. Sometimes you have to do it by formation. Move everyone to one side, and maybe he gets a one-on-one isolated on the backside.
The decision made for him. They've got to go. It's fourth down.
One last shot now for Prescott. Oh, that one sailed a bit, but the catch is still made.
Partner, what a finish to this one. I mean, this offense, they had it down there inside the red zone, but ultimately couldn't execute that final snap to find the end zone.
Yeah, and they're going to walk away from this one, and you know what's going to go through their heads the entire time until they get to play again. If we could only have that final snap to do over one more time, maybe with a different play call.